This is my introduction in to using WeVideo. As you can see, I've already logged into WeVideo and I'm at my dashboard. From my dashboard, I have the option to create a video, create a recording, create a GIF, or create a podcast. In this case, I'm going to create a video. So I'm going to click on the video icon, and this will open up my video editing file. Now, the first thing it's going to ask me is what sort of project I want to, or where I want to save this video, what project I want to save it to. So I've already created a project called Messing About. So I'm going to save it to this project. You can see I've got different ones here that I can choose from, but I'm going to stick with Messing About and I'm going to start editing. This will take me into my video editing file. And I'm just going to walk through the different parts of this sort of screen before I show you how to do different things on the screen. So within my video editing file, I have access to a variety of different menus. My menus are located across the top. If I click on the hamburger, this is where I can save, where I can create a new edit, where I can get some help, where I can look in full screen, where I can just look at my storyboard, or if, where I can use a template. Next to that, I've got this My Video, the words. Now, that's actually the video title. So my current video title is My Video. I actually want to change that. So I'm going to click on those words and a menu will open up where I can rename my video. So I'm going to change it to Helen Test and click OK. So now you can see that my video is now called Helen Test. I also have options for using different themes that are inbuilt into WeVideo or any linked resources, which we don't really have any set up at the moment, but if I wanted to link like a Google Doc, I have that opportunity. Now, underneath, I have my editing menu. So in here, this is where I can access all the different media that I can use to edit my file with. So my first option is stock media. So this is the different media that already become that already comes with the WeVideo subscription that we've paid for. So you can see within stock media, I can actually search for something in particular. So if I want, say, snow and press search, it'll bring up all the stock media that's connected to snow in some way. I can sort of specify whether I want videos about snow, whether I want images or audio, etc. Okay, now my media is where I can access my own media that I've created either on my device or on a different device. And within my media, I have the option to import, which is upload from my computer or from Google Drive. I have the option to record, which will use the camera tool on my device and record within WeVideo itself, or I can narrate, which is like a voiceover over my content. I also have the option to modify text. So this includes captions or credits. These are the text features that come inbuilt in WeVideo. If I can click over one and see what it looks like in my preview window over here on the side. And then if I decide to use it, I can drag and drop it to my pasteboard below. I also have options for audio files. Now, these again are inbuilt into our WeVideo subscription. There are some free music files, there are some sound effects, and then there's also some premium files that I could use if I have a subscription paid for that allows for me to access those files. I have options for transitions. So these are scene transitions that I can place between my scenes to make a more seamless kind of cut or edit. And then I can add on some backgrounds. In the next video, I'm going to show you how to upload your own content and then start using the tracks at the bottom to, or the storyboard tracks to start editing your work.